Alright, welcome ladies and gentlemen, the Mercenary. OneManCast here. Politician. Author. Menace on Twitter. The titles, the names are boundless. And tonight, we're going to try and finish this. But frame drops looking like a pain in the ass. So I'm gonna record just in case. Alright. Where were we? Ah yes, Turnabout Reminisce. Let's get started. I knew I was missing something. I forgot to put it on my fucking Twitters. Let's go. Fancy coat and all, indeed. Thank you. Okay, what the fuck? Beep. Mr. God damn it.
Thank you.
You can be both shortly and in a moment. What do you mean? Dude looks fucking intense. Hey Twilight. Yeah, I've heard news of it at least. $700 and no disc? Come on. It ain't even worth it if it has the disc and a controller and a free game, but no. No, it's totally worth the $700. The economy. Okay, question. Why is there an anthill inside the courtroom? Anyways. Thank you. Edgeworth, no offense, but that's probably not true. I love how every little bit of Edgeworth is just smug. Yeah, rightfully so. I'd lose my fucking marbles. I sleep for a whole fucking day, and all that happens is like the world fucking goes up in flames. Both in the gaming sphere and the other sphere that I am into. Everybody just loses their fucking minds while I'm just sleeping like a fucking, like a bear in hibernation. But, you know, it should be kind of expected at this point. Not that the price is reasonable, but well, that's not... That should never be a standard. But, like, that corporations, particularly Sony, think that's a reasonable price. Like, this should not be a surprise to anybody. We've dealt with this sort of nonsense since the PS3 era. And it just keeps happening. Keeps getting worse every time. Remember when 300 was considered too much for a PS3? Then 500 too much for a PS4? Then like 550 was too much for a PS4 Pro? Then 600 for a PS4 or PS5? And then now 700 for a PS5 Pro? Someone put it best is that it's not a price worth the marginal improvements. Yep, that's why the Xbox 360 got more customers and made more money, because they had a reasonable price for it. It was my first personally owned console, aka a console that I bought with my own money. It was the first console I ever bought with my money. Previously, before that, I was either playing a foster family's game consoles, or before that, my parents would buy it for me. The point I'm making is that companies will always come up with the most unreasonable prices that seem just slightly out of reach of one's normal ability to pay for. And this is just a goalpost move they do, especially ever since the PS3 era, where they just make it at a price that you think is a bit way too expensive. By like $50 to $100 each generation of console. You know, that's what they do. They put this weird psychological pressure on consumers by posing this absurdly high price, but not too high to completely like void the capability of a person to think that they can't afford it. That it's just that tiny little incentive that is like, ah, this is so expensive. You know, I can't afford this, but I want it. You know, it's that sort of psychology. Yeah, I agree. It's a little too much. But it's a proof. What sucks is that it's a tried and proven method for price gouging. They don't want you to feel like you're unable to afford them by an unreasonable margin. They want you to think that the margin of what you can afford is just slightly out of the reach. And that's how they get you out of the $50 to $150 price increase. Nowadays, if I buy a console, I'm buying it from, like, eBay. I'm never buying directly from, like, the manufacturer. All the stuff I buy on eBay. I believe the kids call what Sony does psychic damage these days. Oh joy! Why am I not surprised? Like, guys, you can just hear his fucking monologue. Why do you think I didn't buy a PS5 for a couple of years? I waited for games to be released for it first. Thank you. That's what I like about seeing these fully designed sprites. You can do so much more emotion with these. God, this dude just looks just fucking intense. I'm not sure how you can kill them simultaneously, but okay. They really are siblings. Fuck off with- oh no, no, no. Oh, thank fuck. Can you not fucking do the encoding shit? Can you stop with the encoding? Well, that's interesting. I mean, I don't blame him. I hate it too. But from like a predatory corporate perspective, it makes sense. Like I said, they've been doing this since at least the PS3 era. Just a feasibly just out of reach seeming price. To be further incentive to pay for it. Problem is I think they've kind of hit the cap on that. I think they've kind of lost the plot. You can only pull that shirt for so long. You'd be lucky to get enough people to buy from the developer. Anybody who wants to get that sort of stuff? I will not be surprised with how poor the pro sales will be. And that everybody who has it will probably have bought it from somebody else who bought it. From the manufacturers. Thank you.
You can only pull a trick so many times before people see through it. I can't wait for the PS6 Pro when it's $1,000 to $1,200. Oh god, I hope that... I hope I did not end up making that actually a reality, please. I was being sarcastic. Please, please no. That was meant to be sarcasm. That was meant to be sarcasm, but now watch a Sony person comes randomly, watches my stream for no coherent reason and says, you know what, this is gonna be a good idea. No, 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 no. No, this is not a good idea. I just fucking hate it. I hate that I am able to, like, predict their mindset. Oh god. Question, though. Is Mr. Faraday actually dead? Okay, maybe he is. The reason why I cast doubt is that I see no wounds on the guy. B, there's a blood-soaked bag right over here. No blood in the wound. You could argue that maybe he's dead because, you know, you can't really see underneath him. But you would think that if this guy died, there would be at least blood on top of this guy's back. Also, why is there a smudge? Yeah, that's also very fucking weird. Thank you. Ah, there we go. Yeah, I don't think this guy's actually... I don't think this guy's dead. I don't think this guy's dead. That bloody... Like, I can buy that this guy's dead. Like, the bullet mark makes sense. But are we really going... But, like, it's like the direction of the blade? I don't know about that. I still hold to the theory that Mr. Faraday's actually not dead. Again, it would make sense for the guy. Not what I'm trying to do. Now the guy is... Poor dude. Poor gumshoe, man. What do you think about the current lineup promised?
Because I have a lot to look forward to in 2025, let me tell you.
I'm gonna be filled to the brim with JRPGs. I'm a little hesitant on a Yumiya though. Fountain pen in pocket. But then why is this gun in his right? What? Why is Persona 5 still getting shit? Why? I don't get it. I don't get its popularity. Or why they're milking this shit out of it. It was already a mid-game when it first came out. I knew the bag was a bit, Okay. That makes sense. Okay, I thought it was Atlas making another fucking Persona 5 game. I was gonna lose my fucking mind. Make any sense. How would Mr. Faraday's death be instantaneous? A knife stab, let alone not even one near the heart? That doesn't make any sense. Mr. Rell, on the other hand, got shot. That doesn't make any sense. Fucking thank you. Fucking thank you, Edgeworth. I really appreciate you. Alright, we're gonna press on option 3 here, or statement 3 here. That doesn't work? Again, Franziska, you're a teenager. You should understand that you're not retarded. Franziska. Objection! Okay. So it's not like an official death thing. Okay. That's good. Yes, something is off.
Take that.
It's all right. It's not a dev-made game. That's all I care. I didn't like the base game, and Five Royal looked like it had some potential, but only in the last arc. The order of the bodies fell.
Press on the third statement.
On the revised third statement, we use the handgun. Neither man is what we will pick. Fucking hell. And we're presenting the plastic bag. Yeah. I mean, that's fair. I'm not gonna demean any person who likes Persona 5. But safe to say, I do not think highly of 5. And really, did we really need reload? Motive of the murders. Okay, the fact that her earrings are judge scales is just really funny to me. She's so pompous. Here we go. On statement 5, press.
Hold it.
Raise an objection. Motive for killing Mr. Rell. Fucking god. This encoding issue is pissing me off. Kill this chick. Alright, so present on the first statement, the KGA incident overview. A lot of these characters now have music themes similar to Advance Wars. I want you to just listen in for a minute and just really get the vibe for the Advance War series. Anyways. Who's the victim? I hate this chick. Girl, please tell me your laughter is a coping mechanism. I want to feel bad for hating your guts, but you're really not selling me on it. You are now. Okay, maybe she is, like, coping with a coping mechanism, but come on. Just, like, actually convey this for me so I actually feel bad for hating her guts. Okay, Edgeworth, you're about a hop, skip, and a jump away from being Batman. I have no need for laughter. Thank you. Behind each bench. Hell yes. Okay. Wait a minute. Hold up.
Something's not right here.
That's a bit odd. Yeah, that's a bit... That's a bit suspicious. Maybe she's Yatagarasu. Hey look, they're united. Hey look, it's the Thinker! Yeah, that's interesting.
Yeah.
Interesting. Well, there you go, proof. Oh, I know why the judge didn't see it. Gumshoe is sitting on the bench. His left hand is clearly positioned on it. And because the judge was on the opposite hall, the reason why he didn't see Gumshoe was Gumshoe decided to fall asleep. Calling it. Again, why are you doing this to Edgeworth? I don't like her. By the way, 8 days until the new code Z game comes out. Clearly has a severe Napoleon complex. I guess short people have feelings too. Time to speak to Mr. Bat. I like how Detective Bad does not fuck around. He does not put up with shit from anybody, and I love it. Well, the dude's easily the most intense guy there. Time to hear the gunshot is what we'll pick. We're gonna go to logic now. Windowsill cactus. Pink piece of trash. Well, I was almost right. About 80%.
Oh, you can't be serious.
Well,
oh boy, we're doing this fucking bullshit again. I am so sick of this fizzling out. I think we're back. Hopefully it'll stay this way. I hope and pray it stays this way. Stop fucking around. Oh, no, you fucking dare. Just fucking work. Fucking please.
We're gonna give the judge some correction. Never thought we'd see the day where the judge is a bratty archon. But here we are. Oh my god, just fucking work. Why does it have to keep doing this? Okay, seriously, this recording software just wants to fuck on me. Okay, yeah, this is not working. Anyways, here's what you missed. Yep, total fucking Napoleon complex. That's a bad testimony.
I mean, he's got a good reason and excuse.
Alright, so third statement to get a revise. Press it.
Hold it!
Yeah. I believe it's Swiss roll, right? It's okay, girl. It's okay. We'll be right back.
Alrighty. Okay, so there's that. Thank you. Got a point there.
No, not at all, because, you know... So just like last time, we're just gonna... We're only gonna do one episode.
Thank you. Really? We really pulling a four kids here? Really? I'm assuming this was actually just a part of the fucking, like, original Japanese version. But come on. I thought we learned from this. I'm gonna tell my kids that this is Sanji. Thank you.
Why am I thinking that it's either bad or you that are the Gatagarasu? Thank you.
I have a feeling that, you know, like the Yada Garasu was Faraday.
Sort of.
Oh, hey, I know that guy. New force statement. Balloon piece.
Objection. Thank you.
Dissipating smell. Watches the defense attorney is the one who killed him. Very loud television. When the crime took place. Thank you.
We're gonna finish it right here and now. We're pressing every statement. And the surveillance video.
Take that.
Oh,
Objection!
Window was open.
Pick the perfume here.
New fit statement. Mm-hmm.
Objection!
What? I mean, I'm actually not surprised. I had a guess. I wasn't entirely sure.
Proof of a friendship.
I mean, you could kind of tell with his hair design and his, scarf. What a oddly disjointed friend group.
Alrighty, well with that we are done for tonight. Well, it'll be tomorrow or whatever, but you know what I mean. Remember that my will is absolute. Nah.
Jay.